So we are going to discuss a new chapter, carbon compounds. Yes, carbon compounds. If I ask you to write some things that are there around you and the food which you have taken, the things which are close. So if I ask you to write, what do you write? Yes, you write rice, curry, used to brush toothpaste, and you wore the clothes. So like this, so many things you write, no? Do you know that thing? Many of the things which we use every day consists of carbon. Yes, in our day-to-day life, many of the things which we are using consists of carbon. Even this ink also consists of carbon. Our body and many of the things in our body parts consists of carbon. But in earth crust and in atmosphere, if you are saying, the carbon percentage is very, very, very less. But how this carbon could form this many compounds? Okay, let us see something about the carbon compounds. Now look at this table. Its melting point and boiling points are very, very low. Why these carbon compounds have less melting points and boiling points? Because the bonds between them is very weak. That's why the carbon is having the low, carbon compounds are having the low melting points and boiling points. Okay, why do atoms combine? Means we know one rule called octet rule. To understand this octet rule, we should know about valence electrons. Valence electrons. What are valence electrons? So, Nana, just see. Do you know the atomic number of an element? Atomic number of an element. I told you to by heart elements with their atomic numbers. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium. So like that, you have to by heart the elements with their atomic numbers. So when we write the electronic configuration, two comma, eight comma, eight comma two, this is the best to remember the calcium at the electronic configuration.